folks. I'm Tom Vassell, and welcome to Week in Review. This is a video which we do every week where we talk about the games that we reviewed the past week and tell you what we think of them. Let's get started.
Hey, hey, everybody. Z Garcia here. So last week we put out a new board game, Blender. Go check that out, please. Talking about games where the concept is so ridiculous, it adds to the fun of the game. It's a great episode. Check that out. And then I did several reviews, so here we go. Before I get into the specific game reviews, I also did one of my ranking videos where I went ahead and ranked the different factions that are available right now for Imperial Settlers. This was sort of because I'm getting really excited about the new one that got announced, Amazons. So I wanted to rank the four that came in the base game as well as the two expansion factions that are out there, just according to my own, you know, how much I like them, basically. So check it out. I talked about each a little bit. And then I did a review for a dice game, a roll and write game called Cosmic Run Rapid Fire, which has an interesting theme, sort of a generic sci-fi theme, but it's cool that it's not just colors and numbers, you know, like many roll and write games are. But the game overall, I did not find myself really inspired by. I sort of got the feeling that I was taking a test on one of those fill-in Scantron sheets a lot of the time. I thought the single-player variant was not very interesting, and then it's only a two-player game besides that. If you like sci-fi, and if you want a roll-and-write game that is doing something different than what most of them are doing, then maybe this is a good one for you, but I like what the other ones are doing for the most part, and this one didn't quite speak to me. I reviewed a game called Fairy Tile from Yellow. And this is a very simple but really neat and attractive tile laying and sort of positional game in which you are moving characters on the board, a dragon, a knight, and a princess to try to accomplish something on a card you're holding. As soon as you do that, say the dragon and the princess meet in the forest, discard that card, you draw yourself a new one from your own personal stack, and you're just trying to go through those cards. It's pretty, it's simple, like I said, the little figures come pre-painted, they look very nice, and the whole thing has a breezy feel to it, and could even be considered generic fantasy in this case, but I think that actually works towards it, because it does look like a fairy tale, and it has the artwork is very charming. The whole thing, I think, would go over well with families. And then lastly, I reviewed Sonar, which is a spin-off of Captain Sonar, this, you know, submarine hunting game in which before the original you could have up to four players on one side, four players on the other side, and you were all in real time trying to move and use your sonar to, you know, ping the other team. And then every now and then you say, stop, I'm gonna fire a torpedo. Well, this game has done away with the real time element of it, has simplified the game dramatically, I think. And now you can play one-on-one, two-on-two, that's it, okay? And I really liked it. I played solitaire mostly, and I really liked it, because I get to do both the things. I get to move the sub and use the radar, which was the best part of the original one, I think. And it's the one thing that they mainly salvaged. The other boards in the original were some other, you know, sort of quirky activities to trip you up while you're moving in real time, really. Well, they've done away with that, and I really like the new one. I like it better than the original, and I know I'm gonna play this one more than the original, you know. So there you go, that is Sonar, and that's what I did this past week. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Z Garcia. See you on the next one.
Hey folks, was part of 8 videos this week. First one was a review for King of the Dice. It is a quick little dice rolling Yahtzee style game that also has a set collection aspect to it as well. So it's pretty neat. It was kind of middle of the road for me because while I enjoyed playing it with my family, I thought there were other games out there that are better for a gamer type setting. So I gave it a 5 out of 10. Also did a review for a game called Eye Catch, a memory pattern recognition game that was pretty fun. I enjoyed it more than I would other games of that genre, so gave it a 6 out of 10. Go check that one out as well. Then I also did a review for a new game called Roar King of the Pride. This is a new one put out by IDW. Daryl Andrews and Erica Boyeris are the designers for it there. And really enjoyed this game. My family enjoyed it a lot as well. We actually did a live play of it, so we'd talk about that a little bit. We had a great time playing it. 8 out of 10, a really good game. I enjoyed it a lot. You can check out the details in the video there. Also did another review for some more GameMat.eu products. I did the Highland Terrain set and then also the a double-sided 4x4 playmat that has their Highland Terrain on one side and the Forgotten Realms print on the other. So that was a pretty interesting video to do as well. We also did a What's In There video for Spike Claw's Swarm, one of the new factions for Warhammer Underworld Shadespire. So you can go and check that out and you get to see everything that comes in that box. And then as far as live plays are concerned, we already mentioned the Roar King of the Pride one that I did with my family, three of my four kids. And then we also did a Thunderstone Quest live play with myself and Tom, which was a fun time. Very nail-biting game as well. And then I also did a Memoir 44 scenario between myself and the internet. I thought it was a great time. I really enjoyed myself there. And judging from what the chats were saying, I think everybody enjoyed themselves as well. Good game. Very close as well. So we enjoyed that as well. You can look for another Memoir 44 Me versus the Internet coming this Thursday. So keep that on the up and up. That's it from me, though. We'll see you on the flip side.
Okay, first of all, from me, there is Feudum. Now, Feudum is a big, grandiose Euro game, and I think a lot of people are going to enjoy it. I didn't like it because I found it very fiddly. I found that the game design put form over function, and I didn't like a few aspects of it, like attacking, very much. But there are some really interesting concepts in it, and so some people might really like it a lot. Island Hopper is a silly game that I think I would only play at conventions or so, where you are negotiating over who's the captain. The captain's going to close their eyes and be dropping people off on islands. It's a silly theme. It's a silly game. That's Island Hopper. Ion, this is a drafting game with a science theme where you're collecting elements to put together to form these different chemical compounds. It works really well. It's nice and simple and has a good science theme behind it. I also took a look at the new Clank Mummy expansion, which adds the mummy, of course. Mummy is a fun aspect to the game. It adds two new boards, the Sphinx and the Pyramid, and adds curses to the game. It's compatible with the first expansion a little bit, but it's essentially the same as first expansion. It just adds more stuff, not too complex, and it works well. Melanie and I took a look at a game called Dispatch. This is from Breakout, a group that's all over America that makes escape rooms. And this is like a detective case in a box. It's not really a board game, but instead it's more of a not really escape room type game, but it leans in that direction. And we really enjoyed it a lot. And then finally, Melody and I also took a look at Time Arena. This is a two-player game, which really is just an amazing, fast-paced, 10-minute game where you're moving around, rolling dice. It's a little bit frantic, but not over the top, and has some pretty fun little tactics and strategy in it. I was very, very impressed with this one a lot. And so I also did a couple more Best of Designers over this past week. We finished up all of our Gamma videos, which you'll see. And that's what we did. You can find links to all this stuff in the description of the video if you want to see the full reviews. So go ahead and check that out. Until next time, though, I'm Tom Vassin. You've been watching The Week in Review on the Dice Tower.